Bunsilk Soundbite Films.
We saw the old block indictment, right? And now we're seeing this indictment. And guess what? According to the New York Times, new charging document, other court records show that Fulton County prosecutors have been paying close attention to what? To music and social media output of the Atlanta area rappers.
Of popular rapper Young Thug and more than 20 others arrested on gang-related charges, some of them charged with murder and attempted robbery. An 80-page indictment lays out several of the rapper's songs as evidence.
Let's get straight to Hope Ford. She's been digging into how those words can be used against him. She joins us live in the studio. Hope?
Yeah, the indictment says the lyrics show involvement in some of the crimes those people are accused of, but could there be First Amendment issues? I checked with attorneys to find out.
9 of Young Thug's songs used as evidence, with lyrics such as "I never killed anybody, but I got something to do with that body," and "I killed his man in front of his mama." The indictment saying these words used after the murder of Donovan Thomas, the leader of a rival gang, one of the people charged with his death, a member of Thug's YSL label. District Attorney Fani Willis says,
"I believe in the First Amendment. It's one of our most precious rights. However, the First Amendment does not protect people from prosecutors using it as evidence if it is such."
Legal analyst Paige Pate says it may be hard to use music as proof of a crime.
I have not seen a successful challenge to these Georgia laws that allow that kind of evidence to be used as evidence of a crime in a criminal trial, but I do think that's going to be problematic for the state.
But attorney Daryl Cohen believes, coupled with other evidence, the lyrics add substance.
Just piece by piece by piece, and taken by themselves, they probably don't mean a lot, but when you put them together, what do you have? A big RICO conspiracy.
Using rap lyrics as evidence is not new, but there's conflicting results. Rapper Tekashi 6ix9ine's lyrics were used in his 2018 trial, where it was discovered he was not a gang member, even though he said he was in his songs. In 2016, rapper Tay-K was convicted of murder, using a music video as evidence. And in 2018, rapper Vontae Skinner's lyrics were used in his attempted murder trial. His conviction was overturned when the New Jersey Supreme Court ruled the jury wouldn't have found him guilty if they weren't made to listen to his lyrics. Still, Cohen believes Willis's tactic of using Thug's music as proof of gang activity is the right way to go.
And Thug's attorney maintains Thug's rap label is not a street gang and there's no basis to include the rapper in the indictment. Now, attorneys not associated with this case say even if Thug is a member of a gang, it will be a challenge to prove he had knowledge and intent of crimes committed by other members.
And it alleges that the gang was involved in a wide variety of illegal activities, including witness intimidation, murder, attempted murder, carjacking, robbery, theft, and drug dealing. A number of people are named as victims of shootings or attempted shootings, including Dwayne Carter. Do you remember Dwayne Carter? The New Orleans hip-hop star who raps under the name Lil Wayne, and whose tour bus was shot at by a YSL member named Jimmy Winfrey in April 2015, according to the indictment.
Rich gang or whoever it is in this motherfucker, y'all let them know I said, fuck.
And stop listening to songs that of niggas that post naked on their motherfucking rap car.
Tour buses belonging to rapper Lil Wayne pleaded guilty and accepted a 10-year prison sentence. He had until today to take a deal. Channel 2's cop Kenneth Bureau Chief Ross Gavitt live outside the courthouse with why the DA's tough stance on gang cases may have persuaded the gunman to take the deal.
Man known on the streets as Pee Wee or Roscoe will spend 10 years in prison. The district attorney here in Cobb County believes the gang problem is getting out of control in Cobb and really the metro. We told you about a case last week in which his office asked the judge for a 350-year sentence in another gang case, so it's likely Jimmy Winfrey saw the writing on the wall.
I think it was best for the client to do this and avoid the massive risk if he were to lose even a single count in this case.
Manny Aurora believes his client, Jimmy Winfrey, could have beaten most of the 27 charges in the indictment. But the prosecutorial mood against gangs and gang members in Cobb County is tough.
Anytime you say the word gang and there's an African-American individual, you know, prejudices rear their ugly head, and that's just the reality of the way it is.
Winfrey will spend 10 years in prison for the April incident on I-285. Two buses belonging to the entourage for rapper Lil Wayne came under gunfire. Prosecutors say a simmering rap feud and gang tensions led to it. They believe they could pin Winfrey as the gunman. He was indicted on 27 counts, including a rarely, if ever, used charge that references domestic terrorism. The charges Winfrey pled to are gang-related counts. DA Vic Reynolds making no apology for his take-no-prisoners approach to gang charges.
If you come to Cobb County and you shoot at a bus, thankfully, no one was hurt, but this gentleman shot at a bus over some beef that started in Atlanta. We're not going to tolerate that.
Either you can see the time of day on a 10-year sentence, or you're going to be serving 400 years, as the DA has professed publicly that he would ask on every single gang case.
Well, that domestic terrorism charge is one of those dropped in this particular plea deal. Winfrey faces unrelated charges in other jurisdictions, but again, faces now a 10-year prison sentence in this case. We're live outside the courthouse. Ross Cabot, Channel 2.
Well, there's this phone call, and it looks like this is a piece of the evidence they are using to potentially investigate Birdman. And we told you they're investigating Young Thug also for that bus shooting involving Lil Wayne, when Lil Wayne's tour bus actually got shot up. Now, they have a phone call that was made while Jimmy Winfrey, that's Pee Wee, was incarcerated. And here is what that phone call sounds like.
Cash this phone in and get this money. Well, my name is Brent. You did everything you could do, bro.
Yeah.
It's an eye opener, bro. Yeah, he's probably on the strictly business, man.
Put in a hole there a little bit. Anyway, but preserving, protecting, and enhancing the reputation, power, and territory of the enterprise through the acts of racketeering activity, including murder, assault, and threats of violence. So we also are looking at, through images, songs demonstrating allegiance to the enterprise and a willingness to engage in violence. We also have the use of violence to protect the reputation and the territory of the gang. We also have the unlawful sale and distribution of drugs, illegal drugs. And we also have witness intimidation. So those are the basic five things that they're talking about in the indictment with respect to the conspiracy. Now, here's there are other counts. Now, even though the racketeering language itself has a 20-year maximum, if you're charged with a conspiracy to commit murder, it's still murder, and that is something completely different.
Now, from the outset, this case looks easier to close than a Maybach trunk.
Internet's the trunk closed itself.
Let it pop. That's just the only rest in peace. The simple.
Bunsilk Soundbite Films.